Over the years, the marketplace has become increasingly crowded and competitive. The SME sector is the backbone of major developed economies as well as important contributors to employment, economic and export growth. In South Africa, SMEs account for 91% of businesses, 60% of employment and contribute 52% of total GDP. While in Nigeria, SMEs contribute 48% of national GDP and account for 96% of businesses and 84% of employment. Despite the significant contribution of SMEs to the Nigerian economy, challenges still persist that hinder the growth and development of the sector. And according to the Nigerian Bureau of Statistics, small and medium-scale enterprises in Nigeria have contributed about 48% to the national GDP in the last 5 years, with a total number of about 17.4 million. They account for about 50% of industrial jobs and nearly 90% of the manufacturing sector in terms of number of enterprises. Today on the show, we'll be highlighting some challenges SMEs face and preferring possible solutions. I am Margaret Opara, your host. We'll take a short break now, and after the break, we'll delve more into this topic. So stay with us. You're welcome back to the show. Joining us now is Tosin Wise, CEO, Organize Wardrobe. Welcome, Tosin. Thank you for being on the show.
Thank you, Margaret.
How are you?
I'm fine.
You look amazing, by the way.
You look hot.
Oh, thank you. Hot. Hellfire is hot. Heaven is amazing. So I don't know which you think I look like. Nevertheless, I understand what you mean. So how are you, Tosin? Who is Tosin, first of all? Let's just start with that.
My name is Tosin, and I'm a fashion entrepreneur.
All right.
So also into business, other business like logistics and also hair brand.
Hair brand, wow. So the hair brand is Tosin Wise.
Hair by Tosin.
Hair by Tosin, yeah. Okay, Tosin. So the issue now, the topic we're discussing is startups, some of the challenges startup businesses in Nigeria face. Now, how did you start up? Let's start from that. How were you able to start up this enterprise? Would I call it an enterprise? How was it like for you?
Okay, this beautiful piece started up from my living room.
Whoa, your living room.
So
we were with Palo, yeah? Okay.
Exactly, yeah. My sitting room, actually. So we started 2016, and we tried to test the waters to see how people were going to receive a business idea. What we do basically for Organized Wardrobe is we declutter people's closets. That means you don't wear clothes too much often, you don't like to repeat wears, and you have a luxury lifestyle that everyone would like to also share from you through selling. So you sell what you don't need.
Okay, so from your wardrobe, you pick out the ones you've worn so many times and you're still in good shape, yeah?
Either barely worn, one to the red carpet, once, photo shoots, new with tags, new without tags, not my size, and every other reasons why they are just making your closets cluttered. So you bring them out, send them to us, and we sell to everyone else who are like us. I want to enjoy this, your celebrity lifestyle.
All right, you said you started from your living room, your sitting room. How was it like starting from the sitting room? Did you have the client base? Did you start from social media? Like, what was it like for you? Some of those challenges you want to share with us, yeah?
Okay, we started from the Instagram platform anyway. So we noticed that people were sending items to us because they saw the idea and they liked it. So we thought of, okay, let's start collecting. Let's see how many we can. So we noticed that in less than 1 year, everywhere was littered with bags of clothes, boxes, and we just had to keep it tidy so that when our guests come in, they won't understand what's going on. And we noticed that they just wanted loyalty. They just wanted to be sure that their items are safe. They just wanted to be sure that their money would come back to them and every other thing, because selling things in Nigeria, there are a lot of issues. Sometimes people would just want to be like, oh, are you sure you would deliver and all that? So we just started anyhow, like let's just start. And we noticed that we're just doing something that they liked. And that's one of the reasons that we're still here today. And it gave us there's this point at which we got so that we knew that even if we don't want to do anymore, we can't just go back now. Because everybody will keep checking on us. That was the time we were transiting to this place. We were offline. I mean, we were not doing any activities on our page, and they were calling, asking. So it means that someone is waiting, someone is expectant, and we can't just say we've not seen the impact.
In course of the show, one of the questions I would have asked was how you got your clients to trust your brand. But you just mentioned they want someone who is honest. They want to be sure someone can deliver. So how are you able to make them understand that you can deliver and they trusting you with their properties?
Yeah, we have this feedback session. So when you try to deliver to one person, you pick that music code conversation, probably you screen grab and put on your social media
page. A review.
Yeah, reviews. And then there are times that we do refund, probably because they could not come in like now. Before, they don't have access to come into the place. So, oh, I got the wrong size. I thought you told me the blah, blah, blah and all that. So we just, okay, just overdone. Would get that cloth back from you, and if you want to pick another one or you want a refund, why? Because of this patronage, it has to continue. They have to have a belief in our system that don't worry, even if they give you something wrong, your money is safe, they'll give you back more money or you get something better. So all of this had been in the mind of every other person who knows about organized wardrobe.
Away from organized wardrobe a bit, before we come back to organized wardrobe, startup in Nigeria, you realize that most people now avoid going into businesses because for some people who think business is something you just open a shop and sit in your shop, people will come in. It's not like that. Like you said, social media, you started from Instagram. So what has, can you just highlight some positive effect that the social media have had on startup businesses, including your business?
If we want to talk about businesses right now, a lot of business are not running like before just because there's this huge presence of social media. You don't have the money to get a store, you don't have the money to get an office, and you have an idea. Where your audience matters. Your audience might not even be on the social media platform.
Yeah.
You know where to get them. So based on our own audience, we know that they are youth, they are trendy, they are fashionable. So this is where they are, this is where a lot of them, and more of what we do deals with visuals. So I would say if you know your audience, if you know where you can get them, some audience are probably based on Twitter, they would probably prefer to go and do their advert on Twitter or probably showcase their businesses on Twitter or any other platform. So I would say social media has been a source of energy for everyone who is youthful, young, and still.
Yeah, talking about the youth now, the culture of job creation is not necessarily overriding the culture of job seeking. Now, based on the challenges SMEs face, the institution of SMEs are the youth. So what are the challenges you think the youth face, especially youth who want to start up, the face and starting up their businesses in a country like Nigeria? Let's start with Nigeria. Like I said, the youth are the ones we know are able to drive this institution of SMEs. And now if you look at it, there's a lower percentage of those who want to start up businesses other than those who are looking for jobs. More graduates just want to graduate, have a good job, and only very few. Even though I know now people are now thinking of businesses, but they are still fewer than those who want jobs. So what are the challenges you think the youth are having with this SMEs here?
Most youth are kind of in haste.
Oh, in a haste.
Yeah, some are in haste. Some can't be patient because these things, they are not rocket science. While I was also starting up my business, I was working. So I'd worked for over 7 years in some industry. So during that process, I was preparing. Like, I knew this is where I'm going to. Now, it's even at the point I would kickstart, there are times there will be no sales, there will be no money coming in, and we'll just be waiting. Someone else would have said, this is not for me, this is not my thing. How can money not come in? What else can I do and all that? They would have left that. But it takes a lot of patience, takes a lot of faith, believing in what you have. Whatever business I want to do, I have to just maintain. And there's this power of consistency. When I remember you for something, when I call you back and you tell me you're no more doing this again, oh, you just probably lost that thread. Because me, what if I had gotten that business done and I still probably informed someone else and like, oh, she does this and she did it very well for me. So that power of being there for a long time, it's also part of what the youth need to learn. You don't just jump on something and you mean to look for something that interests you, something you will never get tired of doing, something that makes your mind creative, that makes you want to do more. So I think a lot of youth, they need to be patient enough. They shouldn't rush anything. The business itself, at that young age, it doesn't mean that it should start feeding you, solving all your problems. You need to take good care of this business to a point whereby you can now rest and begin to probably delegate and put other things in place.
Right. Oh, before I wear you out, we have to go on a short break now, but we're back for more. I have more for you on the show, I think.
Thank you.
All right. Tosin mentioned the power of consistency, and so she also mentioned patience as key to achieving whatever you want to achieve. We'll go on a short break now. When we come back, we have more interesting questions and answers for you, only if you stay with us. So stay tuned.
You go enter market, just make you go buy fresh palm fruits. When you reach house, you go wash, you go pound, your body gonna pay you, even your fingernails gonna pay you. But make una no worry, make una relax. I get good news for now. Una don't hear Banga fresh palm fruit extract. All you need to do now make you go for the up, open now. Take the amount where you want, put them for your pot. Which soup you want make? She na egusi, she na ogbono, she na vegetable, she na banga. My sister no waste time again. My brother no waste time again. Just go buy Banga fresh palm fruit extract. The good news say you sabi cook and you be better cook.
Banga, come make your food yummy yum.
Distributors needed nationwide. Phone number 081-6397-4447. 080-3564-4436. 070-6663-8213. Banga fresh palm fruit extract.
Before the break, we've been speaking with Tosin White, and we still have her here with us on set. So thank you, Tosin, for staying with us.
Thank you, Margaret.
Okay. Now, before the break, you mentioned power of consistency, and you mentioned patience. And one of the things you said that struck me is the fact that people, especially young ones, we just started tied up businesses. You said it's not rocket science, it's not magic. You can't just start up a business and expect it to pay your bills immediately. I understand the fact that one of the reasons for starting up any business is to be able
to break out naturally free.
Exactly. But it doesn't happen immediately. This is for the youth out there. You don't just start up something and you expect it to, that is the word, blow, not like Nigerians. You don't just blow like that. But anything that blows like that is a bond charger or a bond battery that blows like that. But well, before then, nevertheless, we'll just go into the next question. So what do you think is the role of the government in making the startup easy for young people? Because recently the president signed the Youth Investment Fund of 75 billion naira, and no youth has come out to say I've benefited from this fund. And recall sometime the president also called the youth lazy, and lots of youth came out saying we are not lazy. I, for instance, I feel the reason why the president had done that is to make the youth prove that since you say you're not lazy, okay, now that's this fund. And nobody has come to say I'm a beneficiary of the fund. So what do you think? See, the youth or the government, what do you think? What exactly is the problem?
One of the things running through my mind for this question is, my first answer is I have not benefited from government. And I have probably information flowing around, and probably I'm not close to that particular one that is positive and is going to give me the results. So most of the times I believe that we do hear from TV, okay, they have this sector, they have this budget, they have this. But I have not seen any of my close friends, any of my far distance friends, any of my
someone relating to somebody, relating to someone, yeah.
Because I believe anything that comes from the government, there will be a way that you can even mention it and let people know. You can't even cover it, because you want to show it to the world that the government sees me valuable, so they invested in me. So I believe anyone who has it out there. But to me, I have not benefited from the government, and I'm still hoping that one day I'll be beneficial to what the country has to support people. But I believe that the government also should engage more in training. Even before we expect this budget, money and all that, we need more of intense training that will get to the roots. Not something that would be only for those who are available at one particular place or something. Something that would be, let's say, batch by batch throughout a year. Let it be like when we hear about JAM. Everyone is aware that it's going to be only holding between May and June, and everyone who is at that age to write is aware. Let people also be aware, like, okay, there's a training for, what's it called? Entrepreneurs use between this particular age, and it will be yearly, it will be probably between a year. There should be a batch that would serve everybody, because we can't just do a one-off and then we just sign this, or probably we expect that maybe the next candidate who is coming on board will do another one. Let it be intense, so that by the time, and once those guys are coming out, let there be finance that is coming after, to support them in whatever you train them for. I know there are a lot of brands trying to do all of this, but how many? We have a lot of people in Nigeria.
So I believe in as much as we have a lot of brands, like for instance, we have a lot of people doing what you do, but you are standing out by God's grace. And also the other people you started with probably that quit, they say I'm not doing it again, they've quit, they've stopped by the way also. So it's not just about, brands will always come up, but that's a distinguishing factor in what you do. I think that's just the power of consistency. Back to that power of, something is bringing me back to that power of consistency.
There are two things. The power of consistency to me is, it's very key. Right. And also excellence in whatever you do. Excellence will help you move. I mean, it will take you far. It will take you beyond whatever it is you have in mind. Every ideas, they have this creative way of expressing themselves to anyone who sees it. As you guys came into this place, probably you might have not even have heard about us, but probably when you came into this, to tell you more about what you perceive about us. You might even be selling, what's it called? Maybe towels. Just towels. I saw a towel store online. I was tripped. They didn't tell me the kind of categories of towels they sell. I believe that they will give me the quality I can use. So it now depends on how people present their businesses and how long they can stay on it without changing and saying, oh, this is not bringing money, let's shut it down. Let's do something that would be valuable. Once what you are serving, whatever you are doing is valuable, people can enjoy your service, then stay on it. Whatever you're doing, people can enjoy the service. I had a lot of complaints. Work on it and make it better. And let them also always remember that you are still on it and you are doing the best. When we started, we were not like this. We started with everything we could just hold on to. Let's just put this together. Let it look like it. I had to do some wallpapers in my sitting room just to express the perception, I mean, the kind of people I want, just to target them. They don't need to know it's my sitting room, but at least I have a way I want it to look like. Then whatever I'm giving out to them, let it be something they will see and tell someone else. Let it not be junked from the streets. Let it just not be something they will give to the needy or probably something meant for, what's it called, NGO or so. You should expect that these people, this is what they look like. You won't pack nonsense and come to this place until you want to declutter.
That's some key things you mentioned. Excellence, which is just what you mentioned now, the power of consistency and patience. It needs to relax, to breathe and allow it to happen, not just rush into it. But then there's this question I want to ask. You know, there's this thing about people trusting brands that has been there before. That's, for instance, I have a smaller brand. I just started selling fish and I go to a place like a big supermarket to say I sell fish, and someone who sells fish in larger quantities has been there. It's easy for them to trust that person, even when I could be better. I could deliver on time, give them the best. I don't sell stale fish, I sell the fresh ones. The ones that have been there before, it's easier to trust them, even if they don't even give me a chance to see if I am better. I'm even better than those people. But is the narrative changing now, or is still static?
I believe it's changing. I believe all of those things that we were used to, the fact that social media is here to stay is changing a lot of things. There's this cake maker online. I noticed that some trend, the way she positioned her business, is attracting authorities to patronize her to get cakes for her for their celebrations. Those set of people would definitely have other people who are making their cakes. Probably they want to make cakes for one RBAC. They know this is the one. But now, a youth like me, in my age, doing it and servicing them, they are old. And I believe they've been celebrating before our existence. So I don't believe that some kind of old, long time businesses would still hold on to power. The only thing I believe is whatever you are doing, do it well. I might be old in this business. If I drop my values, if I drop my excellence, I have opportunity to, as in, just stay back and let other people who are ready to do it well take over me. So I don't believe that someone who is there a long time would continually. Things are changing. If we look at, there's this, what's it called, that just came to my mind, I'm trying to remember. There is a way that people believe that, okay, because they are in it, whoever is coming on board, as far as you are getting it done properly, you can rub shoulders. The only thing that will give you issues is probably what you are presenting to the table looks wishy-washy. And whoever is still in the business before you can do it perfectly, then you still have a lot of work to do. So
All right, so we're rounding up now. So what's your parting shot for young people who want to start up something like yours, or even something different from yours, start up the challenges, preferring solutions to them? What are, like, you had already preferred solution. You mentioned consistency, excellence, and patience. But what's your parting shot?
Okay, my parting shot is, for whatever kind of business you have running or you want to start up, I believe that money cannot be always available in most cases, and even if there is money, the idea might not even be right. Whatever business you want to call, as far as you have it in mind and you are ready, have it in mind that there will be time that there will be low sales or probably low finance or something, business is just kind of quiet. It's every business at its own, they have their own season. It could be a time of rest for you to even rest and rethink. Don't take it as a downtime or probably your spirit's downtime, and look for people to also talk to, people who can motivate you. Have good friends around that you can rub minds with that will help you light up your spirit to continue, because there's this tiring mood that we could get to when business shows you the real color. Business is not for child's play. It's not for the light skin. It's for thick skin.
Thank you so much, Tosin, for having this conversation with us. We hope to have more of you on our segment.
Very well.
All right. All right, we've been speaking to Tosin Y, CEO, Organized Wardrobe. In order to gain exposure, SMEs need to identify or devise their own competitive advantage in order to stand out from the multitude of small business crowding the marketplace. And managers need to move faster and act smarter to keep up with the competition that appears to be increasingly rapid. And this is where we call it a wrap on the show today. Join me next time for more. I am Margaret Opera, and thanks for watching.